Good morning to everyone. I am Dr. M. Balateja, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering of SVR Engineering College. Today we'll discuss how to write and submit a journal. So when we have to write the paper, we'll divide it into two parts. So that is, I have to consider here the two parts as a stage one, stage two. In the stage one, how to preparing the article with the help of tools, with the help of journal writing. And second stage, we'll discuss about the how to submitting a journal, in which paper we have to publish the journal. These two stages we have to discuss. See, when we have to prepare in the article, we require some tools. So mainly our agenda is, when we are getting the low plagiarism with the less grammatical mistakes. So that is our agenda. So that's why with the help of these tools, we have to preparing an article. So here, firstly, we are having a grammatical check. And after that, plagiarism check. And after that, we have to providing reference citation, then citation journal. Here, initially, when we have to prepare the article, before submitting the journal, at that time, we have to check the grammar. So this is the tool is easily available in the web sources, online source it is available. So there we have to finding these two softwares, that is Ginger software and Grammarly software. Here, by comparing these two softwares, the Ginger software is the better software to do the grammatical mistakes in the journal paper. After completion of the grammar checking, then we have to check the plagiarism. So the plagiarism, generally we are using the paid sources. That paid sources software is Turnitin, but it will be cost to find the plagiarism. So that's why in the web source, I have such a lot. In that, small SEO tools and duplicate checker is the main free plagiarism checkers is available. In that, the duplicate checker is the best plagiarism checker software. There we have to easily find the plagiarism. Then after that, we have to consider the citation of the tools. So here, when we have to write the paper, in the finally, we have to write the references. In the references, we have to type the different type of paper. It will be very difficult. So that's why we are having two tools we are having. So the two tools is easily help to cite the paper. So here, Google Scholar and Harvard Citation Generator. By these tools, we have to easily to cite the paper. Then after that, we have to concentrate about the citation in general. If suppose in the paper, see, it is my paper I have written before publication. So here we are having some theory. After that, we are having two references. When we have to put the two references or more than two references, at that time we need these type of tool, that is citation journal. So with the help of these tools, we have easily to write the article. So without having these tools help, it is difficult to write the article. So that's why what I am telling, that when we have to write the paper, after that we have to take these type of tools help, then only you have to write perfectly on the paper. So then now, how to write the article means how to write the journal writing. So here, when the paper you have to write the journal, these are the important factors to write the paper. See here, first initially introduction literature. In the introduction literature, we have to concentrate about the problem identification, aim of the project, and what are the previous authors have done the experience, that experience also we have to put together and get the information in the literature, introduction literature point of view. Then we'll get the problem identification. After that, we have to do that particular work, that particular project or research by the experimental work. If suppose it is experimental mechanically, it will do. If not, we are using some other software help. After that, we'll get some results. So here, in the results, these results we have to show by the pictures or graphs. After that, we'll discuss the diagrams, corresponding pictures and graphs. Then we have to conclude the points of the above experimental work. Then finally, we have to write the abstract. When we know these points, that is introduction literature, experimental setup, results and discussion, conclusion, then only we have to easily write the abstract. Without knowing these, this can't possible to write the exact abstract. So that is the problem we are having. So we have to reduce that thing, we have to thorough in this area. Then after writing the abstract, in the top stack generally what we have, so problem identification of the research, gap of the research, aim of the research, in which previous experience has done by the authors, these four important factors are including in the abstract. Then we have to write the keywords of the abstract or these aspects. So what are the keywords? Means in which material you have done the work, which experimental procedure you are doing the work, what are the results you are getting, and what are the conclusion points you are getting. So these main sources are the keywords you are using in the keywords point of view. Then after that, corresponding these things, you have to add the title of the particular research. Then you have to cite the references. So this is the way to write the article and to write the journal writing. So this is the main criteria of the to write the paper. Now you have to see the my paper. After that you will get easily understand. So this is my paper I have written earlier. So I am ready to publish for the SCI journal. So this is my paper. So first you have to consider the introduction. So this is my introduction. In that, the complete research of my introduction. So there, my aim of the research. And after that, what are the gap identification is that I have written here. Then in this particular research, what is the previous authors has done the experiments. Everything I have written here. And after that, I have to go through the experimental procedure, that is experimental setup. So here I have done my complete research experimental work with the different type of test. So that flowchart I have drawn. Then I have done some test. I have prepared the samples. Then I have done some test. After that, we'll get some results. That is with respect of graphs, with respect of pictures, with respect of graphs, with respect of tables. By these results, we have to write the discussion. We have to written the discussion. After discussion, we'll get some conclusion points of my particular research. So these are my concluded points. And then only we have to write the abstract. Now I will go through the abstract. So this is my abstract. So here in the abstract, what is the aim of my research? What is the gap identification I have done? And what is the previous experience has done by the authors? What I have concluded? Everything is interpreted in the abstract. After that, I have written the keywords. So here you can observe here, these keywords are the main role of the abstract. So after getting the keywords, then I have to object title. So this is my title, that is metallurgical mechanical behavior of aluminum 60616 subjected to deep grinding treatment. Here you can observe here, by using aluminum 6061 T6 with the grinding treatment of the deep grinding treatment of the material, then we have to find the metallurgical and mechanical properties. So here you can observe here which material I am doing the work, what are the mechanical tests you are doing, fatigue, tensile, what is the microstructure test you are doing, microstructure, which process you are doing, deep grinding treatment. So these are the keywords. By these keywords, we have to apply. By these keywords, by this subject, we have to apply title. So this is the procedure to write the complete paper. To write the complete paper, then you have to write the citation. Then you have to write the cite. That is the references. Okay, these are the references. So here, I have written a paper completely before going to publishing, but when before going to publishing my paper, you have to check the paper is correct or not. Means the grammar is correct or not, the plagiarism is correct or not, the citation is correct or not, everything you can check. If it is good, then only you have to submit a paper to the publication. If not, it is not acceptable by the publication. So that's why after returning the paper, I have to check my grammatical mistakes before going to publication. Then plagiarism checking, then citation references checking. Everything I have to check. Now initially what we have to do? You can observe these grammatical mistakes, these plagiarism checking, these citation of the references and these citation will be checked by these tools, by the online source. So first grammatical checking. So here I am using the grammatical checking by these two server, Ginger software I am using. Why? You can observe here, this is my Ginger software. So here we are having two options, that is US and UK. If you want some paper publications are American, some publications are European, that is Britain countries. So corresponding that English, we have to take in, we have to consider. So that's why here you can observe. So whatever the respect country you have to need, some that continent you have to need, that you have to consider here. But here we don't have grammarly software that support. Okay, that's why I have to prefer this Ginger software. Now you can observe here. Now I am observing a grammar of this particular point. I am copying and pasting here. Now I am checking the grammatical mistakes. So here, what is the grammatical mistakes they are finding? So mainly here, the prepositions and pronouns and adjectives. These things are changed by the Ginger software. If it is wrong, it will be add. It will be correct. If it is not there, it will be add. Everything it will be happen. So by using Ginger software. So after written the paper, so you have to check by using grammar, by using this software, Ginger software. Okay. And then you have to get the exact information. Then you have to copy instead of this para, instead of this selected area. Then after that, you have to go through the plagiarism. Here we are having a small SC tool and duplicate checker. Now I'm preferring duplicate checker. It is the free web source. This is online. It will be very freely available. But we are having a Turnitin software, it will be very cost. And apart from that, it will be easy. It will be easy and it will be very free in the web source. So that's why I'm taking here duplicate checker. Now how I can find the plagiarism. So this is a duplicatechecker.com. Now, so this is, I'm taking, copying a para. So now I am pasting. Now I am checking my plagiarism. So here they are asking. right. So plagiarism checking here. You can observe here what will be happen. Scanning is taking place 62%, 92. Right. See here, I have put one para here. After that, I have plagiarized. Then 0% plagiarism and 100% unique. So here we don't have any copy material. Everything has creativity. Everything has new sentences. So that's why I am getting here 100% unique and 0% plagiarism. Total number of hours are checking 184. So it is good. So that's why again I will copy and paste instead of this para. Then after checking the plagiarism, now I will go through the citation, that is references. So references are doing by this type of tools help, that is Google Scholar or Harvard Citation Generator. Now I will go through the Google Scholar. Now here I am putting my title of the paper. Here I am putting my title of paper. Then so here we are getting a double site. Then you have to clicking clear. These type of formats we are having the references, that is MLA, ABA, Chicago, Harvard, Vancouver. So here whatever the title or whatever the publication journal name you have to put here, and after that you have to search in the Google Scholar what are the references styles you need that particular paper. So that site is easily available. Then you have to copy and paste it there. Because if suppose this is the Journal of Ambient Energy, so they generally are using MLA format. That style we are getting here, that format we are getting here. And APA, suppose the Journal of Material Science, suppose example, that journal are following the APA reference style. That style you are getting from here by his Google Scholar citation. So you have to copy and paste it. So this is the support you will get by this tool. Okay, right. If suppose some journals is not available, MLA, APA, Chicago, Harvard, Vancouver, other formats they are using some journals, at that time you will be used Harvard Citation Generator. So that is, this is this one, Harvard Citation Journal. Just you have to, this is journal name, you have to copy. Suppose this is Journal of Mechanical Science and Technology. Just so now I have taken a Springer paper. This is the journal, Springer publication in the Journal of Mechanical Science and Technology. Corresponding to this journal, corresponding to this publication, we are having the different type of citation style. This is different type of citation style. So corresponding this style, corresponding this format or style, you will get by this Harvard. Okay. So this is a Harvard. Okay, so you can observe here. So this is the Harvard. I have to put in here. We'll get different type of journal names. Okay, so here whatever you have to request, that will be cite here. That format you will get. Next. So what I have told you in the paper, when you have to add a, when you have to add a references more than two authors and more than three authors, at that time you have to use citation in journal. So that is the thing you have to hear. You have to take this citation mission, that journal citation mission. Okay. So there in this journal, you have to put the journal name here and such. So corresponding the style you will get here. Like that, after completion of the grammar checking, practice checking, reference citation, then citation of the more than references, then after that you have to submit a paper. You have to submit that paper to a journal. So how to submit a paper? And before that, which journal do you want? That is very important. According to your written document, which journal is suitable for the publication? So that is you have to finding now. After that, you have to submit the paper. So that's why here we are having, when you want to submit a journal, before that, when you select which journal do you want to select a paper, that requires these things. That is abstract, title, keywords. Okay. Before submitting a journal, which journal do you want to submit a paper? At that point of view, these three points are required. That is abstract, title, keywords. So what are the main journals we have in the SCA? Generally, we are having SCA and Scopus or Open Access. So here, these are the journals we are having. So Elsevier, Springer, Taylor and Francis, so IEEE, Ville. These type of journals we are having. So that's why, so now we are finding which journal we want. So that's why first we are going to Journal Finder website. So this is the Journal Finder website. So there we are getting which journal we want to find the paper. So first we have to enter our paper title here. So this is copy. Paste. Then abstract. Journal. This is my abstract. Copy. Next. Copy. Paste. You have to find journal. So which journal is required this complete paper? Now finding the journal publication. So you can observe here, when we are having the OA is there, so that journals are the paid journals. That is the open access journal. It is a premier journal. That means it requires some money. Okay, we don't want that. We have to get in the journals as a free. So that publication we required. So here, when I have to put my title, keywords and abstract, these are the journals are showing for particular my material. So you can observe here, these two points are very important corresponding these journals. So these journals are available corresponding my theory, corresponding my data of my paper. So these two points are very important. Here, this journal is required my paper, but it takes 25 weeks of time to publish. Here, 2 weeks of time. Here, 86 of weeks of time. So here, 2 weeks of time, 6 weeks of time to decision. So 3 weeks of time. So 5 weeks and 2 weeks. So among those, so I'm concerned about only these two points. This is the first decision and time to publish within 2 weeks. Within 15 days, it will be published the paper. And the acceptance rate also 18%. So based on that, I have to consider a journal. I have to find a journal. That is materials and design. So here you can observe here. This is the thing is acceptance rate 7%. Here 37% is there, but here 44% is there, but it is more time. But here only 2 weeks of time, it will take 18% of acceptance rate. So this general is suitable. Okay, so this is open access. If you want the free source also, the S will be shows here. Okay, so that is the important point of view. So now I would like to, so this is you can observe here, 2 weeks and 4 weeks time. So this is also free, the premium and the free source is available. Now I have to consider this paper. So now I have to find this paper is suitable for my returning document. Okay, this journal is my suitable paper. Now I would like to submit my paper to this particular journal. Okay, so here these 2 points, importance, acceptance, impact factor. So now I would like to submit the paper to this particular journal. So submitting paper. Before going to submitting a paper, go to journal website. So here, when you want to submit the paper to this particular journal, first you have to observe the indexing. This is indexing. So you can observe here, the journal is the best journal. How we can identify means only two identifications, two indexing is there. That is mainly SCI Expanded and Scopus. When the indexes are available of this, that is the thing is the best journal. That is the SCI journal, Scopus journal. Suppose SCI Expanded is there, or otherwise SCI only is, Science Citation Index only is there. That is also which is the best journal type of indexing. Then this is the way to index. This is the way to find the indexing. Then you have to go through the submission of the paper, and before that you have to study and identify the guidelines of the authors. After getting the guidelines of the authors, according to that you have to prepare your paper. Then you have to submit your paper to this particular publication. So you have to submit your paper. You have to submitting your paper according to login. You have to submitting your paper. Then the publication will go through the paper will go to this publication. After reviewing of 2 weeks or 4 weeks, then your paper will be published. So this is the way. This is the way we have to publish the paper. Thank you. Thank you so much. And next video, I have to prepare how to get the patents and how to get the financial funding from the different organizations like Department of Science and Technology. From there, we have to find the funding. That is also we have to do the one video for that. So you have to listen and carefully get the information. Thank you.